Hi there, it's Marlene Hielema from imagemaven.com, and in this video I'm going to show you three different ways of how you can show motion. This is great for action and sports photography, or really anything that moves. If this is your first time here, well, thanks for checking me out. I teach photography, photo editing, a little bit of lighting, and I'm a huge fan of Lumix cameras. Please subscribe so you don't miss any of my future videos. So, motion. How do you capture motion? Well, there's three ways, and let's start talking about the first one. The first one is blur. Now, when you choose to blur your subject, it shows the motion, it shows them moving. And to get blur, you need a slow shutter speed. Basically, anything that's slower than your subject. So if it's someone walking, and maybe 1/60th of a second would work to show blur in their legs. If it's something moving very, very fast, you would actually get to use a faster shutter speed and it would still show blur. Now, if you want to blur your subject, I suggest putting your camera on a tripod or otherwise holding it still, because you don't want to have camera movement and subject movement at the same time if you can avoid it. So basically, throw your camera on a tripod, set up your shutter speed, and off you go. Let's look at some sample photos that use blur creatively. Now the next technique to show motion is called panning. And when you're panning, you're following your subject across the plane of view and you're following them at the same speed as they're moving. So this works for runners, cyclists, perhaps racing cars or motorcycle races. But the key is that you want to move your camera the same speed that the subject is moving so that the subject isn't blurry, like in the first example we talked about with blur. Now, in terms of shutter speed, you want to be fast enough to kind of freeze the motion, but you still want to blur the background. If you're in the forest, like I mentioned, shooting perhaps a mountain bike race, I found that around 1/60th of a second, 1/125th of a second works great. You might still get some motion of the person who is doing the sport or whatever, because maybe their legs are turning on their pedals or things like that. So just keep that in mind. You don't want to have your shutter speed so slow that you get too much motion. Here's another tip about panning. You can use fill flash when you're panning, and that's kind of a pop and drag kind of technique it's called. So you're going along and you're pressing your shutter and pop, out comes a flash, but the background is blurred. Another tip is that you can actually pan in any direction you want. You don't have to pan side to side. You can pan circular, up and down, diagonal. Panning is really fun. It's kind of like playing with light. You're dragging those light rays around onto your sensor or your film. This works with film too, of course. Okay, let's look at some examples of panning. All right, and the last technique is freezing the motion. And this is the most common way that we portray sports. I use freezing the motion all the time when I'm shooting my skateboarding. When you freeze the motion, you need a fast shutter speed. Fast enough so you don't see any movement at all in your athlete. When I'm shooting skateboarding, I like to use at least 1/1000th of a second. If I'm shooting a faster sport, like a motorsport, you're going to need a super fast shutter speed to freeze the motion. Now, if you're doing this indoors, guess what? You might not have enough light to freeze the motion. And that's what I find with my skateboarding. If I'm shooting at an indoor skate park, I need to use a super fast lens and a high ISO in order to freeze the action. And that is the challenge. So for me, I prefer to shoot action photos in outdoor, natural, sunlight, daylight kind of situations. Cloudy's fine, but I don't like shooting action in like gymnasiums and dark hockey arenas. That's a real challenge. Let's look at some examples of some freeze motion photos, and I've included the camera settings for your reference. I like to shoot sports and action photography using shutter priority, and I control how the image looks by changing the shutter speed, whether that's blur, pan, or freeze. One key factor when shooting athletes or any kind of action photography is getting your timing right. Now, the timing has to do with the decisive moment, and the decisive moment has to do with, is the lighting good? Is the composition good? Is the athlete in peak form? And are they performing their trick at the utmost peak moment in that motion that they're doing? So if it's a skateboarder, it has to show that peak moment of the trick, that decisive moment. And all of these elements have to come together at the same time to give you the perfect timing, the decisive moment of your shots. And those are the shots that are most successful. One thing I have found is that athletes actually help me choose the photos that work for them, because I don't know the ins and outs of every sport. I have learned over time what those peak moments are in skateboarding, but I'm not familiar with every sport. So you definitely want to get feedback if you're shooting high-end athletes about what that peak moment is. And one thing that can really help capture the decisive moment or getting your timing right is shooting in burst mode. So in the case of my Lumix G9 here, I'll shoot in high speed burst, which is 12 frames a second, or super high burst, which is 20 frames a second. And I don't usually need anything more than that to capture things like skateboarding, which is what I mostly shoot action of these days. But if you're shooting something super fast, like a motorcycle race or a car race or something, you know, there's not a lot of change in the car from one position to the other. But if you're shooting the finish line, you definitely want to get, you know, the car that's going over first. You want to get that finishing shot. Or think of a horse race. You want to get those horses as they're crossing the finish line. You want to get that decisive moment and see who wins. Now, one more thing I'd like to say is that action and sports photography is very hard. You have to put in the time. You have to practice a lot to find the timing of the relationship between your eyes and your shutter button and the athlete. And the timing is really critical. And the timing is the hardest thing to learn. Anyone can learn the camera settings. That's really easy stuff compared to capturing that decisive moment. Now, hopefully you have a friend or some children or somebody to work with that will go out with you and shoot a few times for a few hours and let you practice and fiddle with the camera settings, but mostly to get the decisive moment. That's the key. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below this video. See you next time.